Good morning, it's Don Thornton here. It's day 48 on my journey to escape diabetes and stage 3 kidney disease. I just want to, I wasn't available yesterday. I was completely swamped. I was driving most of the day. Then I had a training to go to, then I had to get a bunch of stuff done. So I just didn't do it. Although I did keep track of my weight. And speaking of the weight, let's get on the chart and see how I did. And I tell you what, this is going to be an interesting discussion here because you can see that I gained some weight here. For over a week now, I have been going from 218 to 218 and a half to 217 and a half and so on and so forth. Now I went back up to 218 and a half. Now, the only thing I can say is that the Friday and Saturday, I was driving a lot again. And when I drive a lot, it just, that seems to be a correlation to me either not losing weight or putting a little bit of weight on. But I don't know. I mean, honestly, for the last week or so, I really haven't had much progress, I would say. I seem to have hit a plateau. And everybody I've talked to has warned me that that's going to happen, that, you know, once you get, you know, when you start off really well, lose a lot of weight, and then you hit a point where you're going to hit a wall, and it's going to be harder to lose the weight. I don't know what to tell you, because honestly, I'm really not doing anything different than I was doing the entire time before. I mean, the exercise is still there. You know, I still am not eating carbs hardly at all. You know, it's just some protein and some veggies and some fruit. That's really what I've been eating, and which is pretty healthy. It's actually pretty darn healthy, you know, but for some reason, what was conducive to losing weight before is not helping me now. And, you know, I've been hearing people tell me, you know, hey, you need to fast for 3 days, you know, and, you know, or, you know, just only eat for 6 hours at a time, you know, during a 6 hour time or whatever. I'm thinking to myself, that's pretty much what I already do anyway. I mean, I eat like at 6 in the morning, and then I have my lunch, and I don't hardly eat anything, you know, in the evening anyway. So I'm kind of already doing that. I don't want to fast right now, because I tell you why, because I'm already sometimes with the lack of carbs I'm eating. I mean, it was just to give you an example. Yesterday I went to Jacksonville and I had to change a lock. And part of what you do when you're, the banks put up lock boxes and they put keys inside. And so what you have to do is you have to get bolt cutters, and you have to cut the bolt, the handle off, or the, what they hang it on the doorknob. You have to cut that off with bolt cutters, and you have to go to the trunk of the car, get a flathead screwdriver, because there's a, you turn the lockbox around, I mean, and you look at the back, the bottom of the back, there's like a little notch, a slit there that you put your flathead in, and you can just kind of pry it open, and you can open up the back, you can open the bottom of the lockbox and get the key out that way. And I remember yesterday, you know, when I got done with that, my hands were kind of shaking, you know, already, you know, and it's just like I already feeling the fact that I don't have that much energy like I was, because, you know, actually in some ways I was eating some more carbs at the beginning of the journey than I am now. I mean, the last 2 weeks I hardly had any carbs at all, and ironically speaking, I'm losing less weight now than I was when I was eating a few more carbs back in the day. I would have some buckwheat. I had some grits every now and then, you know, and it seemed like I was doing much better on my weight loss then than I am now, when 2 weeks ago I decided, okay, I'm cutting all carbs out. I'm at the point now where I think, I don't know what the fuck's going on. Sorry for my language, but all I know is like, I'm just going to stay with what I know. And what I know is the fact that I got a diagnosis, you know, on February 22nd, that said that if I don't cut out sugar and carbs and eat right, and no junk food, none of that stuff, then I'm looking at an early grave. And so, foremost in my mind always is that principle, is that no matter what, I am not going to go back to the old way of eating. Those days are over. As far as the next, you know, 18 pounds to get down to 200, I don't know what's going to happen on that one. I mean, I may get to the point where, you know, 90 days in this challenge, I'm still in the mid 210, you know, 215 or whatever. I don't know. But I'm just going to keep living this day by day, because I don't have any alternative. There's nowhere to go back to. So a little bit of kind of a sad, not sad, but a little bit, you know, disappointing week and a half, almost 2 weeks here. But what can I say? I mean, it is what it is. And I know it sounds trite, sounds cliche-ish, but I don't know what else to say. Is it? That's where I'm at. Anyway, here we go. That's what's happening. Tomorrow will be the end of my seventh week. I start the second, you know, week eight, officially on Tuesday, which is like a, you know, pretty much a 2 month mark. My 60 days is coming up here shortly, in about 10, well, shortly, in about 11 days. So, you know, that'll be a milestone, but, you know, just keep moving forward one day at a time. Another cliche for you. All right. I'll see you. I'll stop my share and I'll talk to you tomorrow.